Welcome back. Several homeowners in West Mobile say they're worried about a new low-income housing development. The Mobile County Commission will vote on a package of tax incentives tomorrow related to the arbors at McFarland. News 5's Chad Petrie has that story.
This massive overgrowth and brush doesn't look like much, but it's causing a stir with the neighborhood next door.
I'm just concerned, you know, as I am with any neighbors or any neighborhood.
Ron Rowell has lived here for 30 years. The proposed affordable housing development includes 70 units just a couple hundred feet from his home off McFarland Road. A lot of neighbors I spoke with didn't want to show their faces on camera out of fear of offending someone.
And I know the police are very good about patrolling out here and trying to keep it safe, but no, I don't want it out here.
Crime in the neighborhood. That would be one of the concerns.
Many of the homeowners I spoke with weren't even aware of the project, but some of those that were still had a lot of questions.
So I would like to know, is it approved? I'd like to know, is the taxpayers, are they looking for a grant to put this in?
Jeff Lind voiced the most common concern. There's too much traffic along McFarland, and with one subdivision under construction, he says their neighborhood can't handle more.
Everyone on the outside of the subdivision uses as a way to shortcut several intersections. I don't see that getting any better. In fact, I see it getting worse.
Newly reelected County Commissioner Jerry Carl agreed, saying traffic is the main issue if a housing development replaces the debris. In West Mobile, Chad Petrie, News 5.
And Carl said he'll vote no Monday. We have not been able to make contact with the developer or the company behind the project because we have yet to find out who it is. We've asked a county commissioner, the county attorney, and the county spokesman for that information and still don't have it. So we've been unable to reach out to the developers for any comment. A county commission meeting is slated for Monday morning at 10 a.m. at Government Plaza.